text for popping the cork is taken from Proverbs 19:19, and this is the ESV version. A man of great wrath will pay the penalty, for if you deliver him, you will have to do it again. In other words, his great wrath, if you're the rescuer, is going to occur again and again. It's not until that person makes the decision to change. And our lesson is going to demonstrate this. Slide number 2, the materials you need, and you may not have it, but this is what I'm using, is a soda pop bottle. Now, it's a brown bottle. I'm sorry. I wish it was a clear bottle, but it's a root beer bottle. I'm sorry. You need a, it's a glass bottle. I'm not sure if you can do it with plastic bottles or not. I was afraid to try. But anyway, so we need a, I have a glass soda pop bottle, a cork, some vinegar, 5% vinegar, baking soda, and on the cork, I put some little streamers, because when we did this experiment at home yesterday, that cork was out. You couldn't see where it went. You could just hear it knock over there on the wall. And so I put some ribbon streamers. I don't know if that will help direct our attention. And we have an open door to the office. And I'm going to aim for that. I don't know if we'll get there or not. But first, let me just speak a little bit more about what we're trying to demonstrate. An uncontrolled temper often leads people to saying bad things and to doing wrong things, saying bad words, doing wrong things. I'm on page 3 of our little slide presentation. It results in poor decisions being made, and often relationships are broken because of this temper that some people have. And the results of the flaring your temper are often worse than what the problem was to begin with. Our text tells us, sadly, a hot-tempered person doesn't easily learn patience, and he repeats the error again and again. An uncontrolled temper is going to be demonstrated in this bottle. And into this bottle, we first add. Now, the book that I got this from said, add, yes, you can do it, Ashley, 2 tablespoons of this. And we did that, and we had an eruption. So what we're going to do is put 1 tablespoon in of baking soda. And then the next thing, I don't know who wrote this book. It's supposedly a scientist. And he said, put a whole cup of vinegar in, and I did. And we had to tame it down to about a 1/4 cup of vinegar. So I'm going to measure off a 1/4 cup of vinegar. You can. And this is really fun to do. We had fun. The first time, whoo, it was bad. The second time, we tamed it down a little bit, and we just had a spurt coming up like a hot spring. And it was in the kitchen sink, by the way. So let's just get everything out of the way first, Ashley. I'm going to move all our supplies down here. I have a towel here to cover any.
It's going to spill.
It's going to foam out. But I hate doing this, but we're going to do it. I'm quickly going to pour this vinegar in there. Ash is going to seal it down and aim it toward there. You got that? You ready? Are you sure? Okay, here we go. 1/4 cup of vinegar goes in.
Okay, stop.
Go for
stop.
Aim. Whoops. No, you shouldn't hold it.
You'll be sorry. Aim.
Did you?
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. I'm always. Who's going to volunteer to open this up? Knock, knock, are you there? Wait a minute. I think the teacher should do this. Okay, we're going to add more.
You didn't put it.
So we're going to do it one more time, and then I quit. I wish we had.
Would you like help?
Would you like to help?
Well, someone has to run the camera.
Okay, Ash, just a minute.
Why don't you put the vinegar in first?
Well,
maybe you should take that old out and put new in.
Yeah, you're supposed to put old, take the old out.
Well, nevertheless.
Just put a bunch in.
I'm putting them all in. You may be sorry. Where's this cork?
It's already forming.
Put more in. Just go for it. Hurry.
Are you sure?
Yeah, go for
no!
it. Now.
Ah! Oh! I went out the door! All the way to the car!
I'm see the stream of...
Okay. That time it worked. The moral of the story is, you never know when someone has a bad temper when it's going to erupt. But we do know that certain factors can affect it. Just like when the vinegar and the baking soda were mixed, carbon dioxide gas was formed. And we plugged up the bottle and the gas just built up and built up until it popped the cork and sent it off. Now, we could have timed this. It's unpredictable how long it will take to pop that cork because there's so many factors involved. But if we had timed this and had the courage to try again, but shaking the bottle first, do you think that cork would have popped sooner?
Yes, sir.
I think so. And so do you remember a few weeks ago we had the lesson that a soft answer turneth away wrath? And so if you know that someone is agitated, irritable, something's going wrong, that's not the time to start telling that person, oh, what you don't like about that person, or what that person should have done that hadn't have done it. We need to have soft answers to help this person who hopefully is going to God to gain the victory over temper. And I can say firsthand that I know what that's like. Because my cork popped often when I was younger, but every time I ask God, I'm so sorry, please help me. And He has performed a miracle, and now you can shake up the baking soda and the vinegar, and usually I'm kind and sweet about all things. But God can change us. And in the meantime, we want to remember our soft answers and not to agitate problems. Because if we had agitated this soda pop bottle, it might have gone off in our hands. And so we want to remember that God can help us in all things, and we want to be good brothers and sisters to one another. Thank you.